Number 17. Now, this one also is coming up with an equation. This time it's, we're saying D equals. An object moves in simple harmonic motion. Harmonic motion is one of the words we use for a sine or a cosine function. So we've actually got a graph. It's told it has a period of 6 minutes. So we're going to kind of sketch out this graph, and then we're going to have, again, a equation in either sine or cosine. 6 minutes of amplitude, period of 6, and an amplitude of 11 meters. You know, so that's the size of the wave. We're told at time t equals 0 minutes, its displacement d from rest is 0. So we start at 0, 0. This, to me, is looking like a sine. We'll get there. And initially, it moves in a negative direction. So that's important. So let's sketch this out with the information we've got. So what they are telling us is we've got a sine wave going on. So let's, so we've got a sine wave. We know we start at, let's see, let's draw it in red. Okay, we start at 0, and we've got a period of 6 minutes, so we'll mark that in a moment. What else do we know? Amplitude of 11, and we go in a negative direction. So an amplitude of 11 meters, and we're going down, and we go up, and we go down, and we go up. Okay, so amplitude of 11, so it means this is negative 11, and up here, this is positive 11, starting at 0, going down, and then one full cycle. So from beginning to the end of the cycle is 6 minutes. Okay, one wave. It doesn't mention anything about a vertical shift or anything else. So how can we do this? So we've got period, we've got amplitude. That's really all we've been given. The thing is, now remember, for a standard sine function, sine function does start at 0, but it goes up. So this would be the regular sine, right? Sine by itself. What this must be, this must have a negative on it. That's what's causing it to go down first. We've flipped it. And so what we've got is we've got our amplitude. So we can say the displacement is equal to, y equals negative 11 times the sine. And now we've got to figure out our value for b, right? This is y equals a sine of bx. We'll do the simple one because there's not talking about any phase shift. We don't have to talk about no vertical shift. So period, remember, period is equal to 2 pi over b. So this is one. We know the period is 6, so we've got 6 equals 2 pi over b. Cross multiply, so we get 2 pi equals 6b, and then divide by 6. B is going to be pi over 3. X, but they want a t. They want their variable to be t. So make sure you use the right variables. Displacement d as a function of time t. Okay, so come over here. Minus 11 sine of pi over 3 t. And again, I like to have these parentheses because that's what a function is. It's just an input to a parentheses. No need for square roots in this one. Okay, so that is question 17.